Hey guys, this is John with Greenfish Nation. I want to welcome you to the channel today. Guys, we're right in the middle of the fall transition here in October. Today we're going to be showing you guys how to rig up one of my favorite fall time rigs. It's called the double fluke rig or the donkey rig. I'm sure you guys might have seen it, so you guys stay tuned. We'll show you how to rig up this double fluke rig or the donkey rig. All right, guys, in order to save time here, we're kind of limited on our afternoon sunlight here. I went ahead and rigged up this donkey rig. I'll break it down for you a little later in the video exactly how we rigged it. So, guys, hang tight. We're going to get to fishing with this donkey rig and see what we can pull in. So, you guys stay tuned to Greenfish Nation for some donkey rig action on the honey hole. All right, guys, I'm throwing this just on a standard bait casting rod like you would throw a crankbait or a jerkbait on. Yep, that was the first cast. I literally twitched this rod 2 times. He hit the front one. Stephanie's over there jerking out of the water left and right on a Senko, but I think she switched to a fluke now. You'd think that this rig would tend to get hung up quite a bit, but actually, surprisingly, it don't. Real good friend of mine that I work with, he's actually one of my supervisors. Jeff Sanderson's the one that told me about this little rig. About the fanciest thing around was a Carolina rig. They had started drop shotting a little bit here in Texas, but that was mainly a California thing. But Jeff turned me on to this donkey rig, so he said it's not a new concept, but we thought we'd try it out, so y'all hang tight. There's another one on the old double donkey. He also hit the front bait. These guys are chasing bait today. We got a little old tournament down in Palestine here in about 2 weeks. I hope we can hopefully capitalize on some of these fish about this size while we're down there. I know my high school kids would really enjoy taking in a limit of fish. There's a way in. Able to cover two parts of the water. Well, I believe that. Nope, I believe he's still on there. Nope. He got off, but he was two spectrums of the color, that way I guess you'd say, light and dark. I was down there trying to get Stephanie's spot while she was out getting a worm,
right.
Trying to cheat her out of some fish there. On another one down there. I had to quit taking her fishing with me because every time I took her, she outfished me. Made me look bad. So if I've been inviting you to go fishing and you go with me some and you always outfish me, just know that if the invite stopped, that's probably what it was. Thank you. who it seems to be doing it today. Not too bad. A little pinto in some fish. Already a fish on there, guys. I think he must have hit it right whenever it went in the water. A little cuss, he ain't hardly bigger than a bait. All right, guys, another bait change. I wore the nose out on that one. Let's get back out here and see what we can do here with this donkey reel. Really. I just missed one right there. Guys, I'm going to show you how I rig up my donkey rig. I want to first go over with you the elements that you need to rig up this donkey rig. You're going to need two barrel swivels, two hooks of your choice. I like the 2-aught wide gap hooks. I think these are Gamagatsu. And then you'll need two flukes of your color and size choice. Also, you might like the paddle tail better than the regular fluke that just has the split tail on it like a normal fish. But anyway, guys, I'm gonna show you what we do here. All right, the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna run me out about 5 foot of line here. And I'm gonna clip that off. My little clippers. By the way, guys, I've got these Boomerang Tool Company nippers. They work great with braided line or monofilament, either one. They do wonders with either one of those. But the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take one of my barrel swivels, slide it on the line here. I'm just gonna let it free flow down the line. And then I'm gonna take my second barrel swivel, tie that on my main line, and I'm just gonna use like an improved clinch knot. Don't forget to moisten your line or could cause you to have failure there. Snip that off. Next thing I'm gonna do is I'm going to tie to this leader, to this other swivel. We'll tie my leader on it, and I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to do the clinch knot. Now, I'm going to show you guys a neat little trick here so you can get your lines the exact length that you want them. Take a little of the guesswork out of it. All right, now the other end of this line, I'm going to take right down here. And I'm going to tie it to this free-floating swivel. All right, what I got here is I can choose the lengths of my line by where I cut them. So I'm gonna come up at about 2 foot with this one, and I'm gonna cut it right there. All right, guys, when you got that loop and you cut it, you can adjust your line lengths. I always like to try and keep my shorter line on the main line, so that way I can tie my hooks on. Same thing, I'm gonna twist this around about 5 to 6 times. I'm gonna use that improved clinch knot. Got one of them tied on. And then I'm gonna tie my other one on. There we go. Lubrication, pull it down good and tight, flip off my tag end. Now I'm gonna rig this up with two floats. I think these are called Arkansas Shiner or something like that. I can't remember, but I'm just gonna go up to the bend of the hook. gonna put this on there. Mark my spot where I want this to come through at. Pop that through there. I'm gonna skin hook it on the back because where I fish is a lot of heavy cover and brush. I'm gonna get my other fluke. Now you can do these in different colors, different sizes even. You could do like a large 6-inch in like a baby bass color, chasing a small 3-inch in a like a shad type pattern, white with a silver glitter. But guys, that is what the finished donkey rig looks like. But guys, I hope this tackle tip helps you. I appreciate you joining us. I hope you enjoyed the video today. We'll get back to that and finish it up.
Feels like a little bit better fish. Better fish than we've been catching.
I tell you right now, I take five of them at that tournament. That'd make for a 15-pound sack. A little better fish there. I'm gonna get this hook out of him. He's ready to get back in there and start eating some more. About a 3-pounder right there, guys. Like I said, I'd take five of them for sure at that tournament. It might not win it, but they'd know we've been there. Let's get out there and see if his brother's out there. Or his mama. Apparently, good backlash is what we needed. That's a pretty good size little chunk on it. On the donkey rig there. But once again, I appreciate you joining us. Hope you enjoyed our content today. Guys, if you did, click that subscribe button down there. Hit that like button, that old thumbs up. And don't forget to hit that notifications bell so you'll know when we post a new video. Until next time, I'm John with Greenfish Nation, and I want to wish all of you tight lines, guys.